Hello everyone, welcome to another lecture of Cold War series. In this video, we will continue the story of Cold War and we'll study the Berlin blockade. Let's start this lecture now. First of all, an overview of Berlin blockade. The Berlin blockade was an attempt in 1948 by the Soviet Union to limit the ability of the United States, Great Britain and France to travel to their sectors of Berlin, which lay within Russian-occupied East Germany. Soviets blockaded all rail, roads and canal access to the western zones of Berlin. Suddenly, some 2.5 million civilians had no access to food, medicines, fuel, electricity and other basic goods. Eventually, the Western powers instituted an airlift that lasted nearly a year and delivered vital supplies and relief to West Berlin. The Berlin blockade and the Allied response in the form of the Berlin airlift represented the first major conflict of the Cold War. Background of Berlin blockade. At the end of World War II, the United States, Britain, France, and the Soviet Union divided the defeated Germany into four occupation zones as outlined at the Yalta Conference in February 1945 and formalized at Potsdam later that year. US, UK and France agreed on unification of three zones of Germany which came under their control. In this way, Germany was now divided into two parts, Western Germany and Eastern Germany. Western Germany was under the control of the United States, UK and France, whereas Eastern Germany was under the control of USSR. Being the capital city of Germany, Berlin was also supposed to be divided among the four players, including United States, UK, France and USSR. As it is situated in the eastern side, therefore Berlin and all the territory along it was in the control of USSR after the division of Germany. But USSR had to give Western Berlin to US, UK and France. Berlin blockade by USSR. After unifying their three zones, US, UK and France introduced new currency in the Western Germany, which devalued the currency of Eastern Germany. Viewing this as a violation of their post-war agreements, the Soviets immediately issued their own currency into Berlin and Eastern Germany. That same day, on June 24, 1948, they blocked all roads, railways and canal accesses to the Allied occupied zones of Berlin. They announced that the four-way administration of the city had come to an end. With their blockade, the Soviets cut some 2.5 million civilians in the three western sectors of Berlin off from access to electricity as well as food, coal and other crucial supplies. Though the Red Army far outnumbered Allied military forces in and around Berlin, the United States and Britain retained control of 320-mile wide air corridors from West Germany into West Berlin, according to written agreement with the Soviet Union from 1945. After this blockade, there was no direct link for US, UK and France to access the West Berlin. USSR had blocked the western borders of Berlin, whereas eastern side was already in its control. Largest air relief operation. Beginning June 26, 1948, 2 days after the blockade was announced, US and British planes carried out the largest air relief operation in history, transporting some 2.3 million tons of supplies into West Berlin on more than 270,000 flights over 11 months. End of blockade. While USSR had hoped the Berlin blockade would force the Allies to abandon their efforts to create a West German state, the success of Berlin airlift confirmed such hopes were in vain. By May 1949, when the Soviets lifted the blockade, the crisis in Berlin had hardened the east-west division of Germany. The blockade could not give the desired results to USSR. Instead, it hardened the division further. So, this was all from today's lecture. The story of Cold War will be continued in coming lectures. Thanks for watching this video. Like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon for more videos. Goodbye.